to come between people and God. The scribes and the Pharisees were content with self-righteousness. And it says, if you continue this way, you're going to be lost. If you continue to believe that my power comes from the evil one, if you continue to insist in this opposition, you will be lost. Jesus is issuing a strong warning. Repent. Repent and believe the gospel. The Pharisees had huge books of laws for us about what you could and could not do in the Sabbath. They believed that you could earn your way to heaven. They believed that. And Jesus said, if you reside in that belief, there is no hope for you. I can't save you. Verse 31. And his mother and brothers arrived, and standing outside, they sent word to him and called him. Well, it was interesting that the crowd, they didn't open a path for the paralytic. They didn't open a path for Mary or Joseph's children. Not much respect there, was there? So they send the message, Jesus, please come out. John 7:5, for even his own brothers believed not. His own brothers didn't believe. Verse 32, and a multitude was sitting around him, and they said to him, behold, your mother and your brothers are outside looking for you. And answered them, he said, who are my mother and brothers? Verse 34, and looking about on those who were sitting around him, he said, behold, my mother and brothers. For whoever does the will of God, he is my brother and sister and mother. And your brother Jesus, do the will of God, your brother of Jesus. Desire of Ages 3:24, the only defense against evil is the indwelling of Christ in our hearts through faith in his righteousness. Unless we become vitally connected with God, we can never resist the unhallowed effects of self-love, self-indulgence, and temptation to sin. We may leave off many bad habits. For the time, we may part company with Satan, but without a vital connection with God, through the surrender of ourselves to him moment by moment, we shall be overcome. If we do not surrender ourselves to Christ daily, we end up doing the bidding of the evil one. Jesus' family arrives. They pass the word along. We need to speak to our brother. Mary needs to speak to her son. And Jesus raises this question, who really are my brothers and my mother? And he says, whoever does my will. Now, Luke 11 gives us a little insight on this, of what the scribes said when they called him Elizabeth. He says, when it came about, he said these things. One of the women in the crowd raised her voice and said to him, blessed is the womb that bore you, and blessed which you nursed. But he said, on the contrary, blessed are those who hear the word of God and observe it. Jesus doesn't settle for the physical relationship, but for that spiritual relationship.
Amen.
Jesus invites us to be part of his intimate family, to walk by faith to him. Every day you and I have a choice to make. Will Jesus be the God of our life? Or will Satan be? You know, the part of the sin that he's addressing here with the scribes and the Pharisees is that they have come to the place where they rejected the influence of the Holy Spirit to protect what they believed about God. To protect their belief that if they worked hard enough, they were going to heaven. And you know, the devil's always trying to get that into our church. His idea, if we work just hard enough, we'll make it to heaven. And I've heard people say that, if I work just hard enough. And Jesus is saying, and here in Mark 3, it's not working hard enough. It's not having your names on the book of the church. It's not being born in an Adventist home, but it's having a joyous and intimate and authentic relationship with Him. That's what gets us to heaven. He does all the heavy lifting. He asks us to surrender and to follow. He asks us to be His witness, to be His hands, His mouth, His feet. He asks us to not let our friends be tied down by Satan and his addictions. He asks us to, by the power of Christ, to touch people's lives and give them hope. And he asks us to preach. As I said, preaching isn't always word. Our most powerful preaching is how we treat each other and how we treat others. So I hope this week you'll be a disciple of Jesus Christ, because you're empowered by Jesus. Not because you feel like you have to, but because you love Jesus. And you want everybody you know to be in love with Him as well. Let's pray. Father in heaven, we leave this place with a whole new week ahead of us, a clean slate, with opportunities to be kind, caring, and compassionate. Lord, there are people out there who don't believe in you. There are people out there who are very cynical toward the church, and honestly, Lord, we've given them a lot of good reasons for them to be cynical. But help us, Lord, to be your hands and feet and your mouth. Help us to touch people's lives so they will ask, why do you do such things? And let our answer be because we love Jesus. Pray in the name of your Son. Amen. Amen.